from time to time, I'll have a conversation with someone who will say something along these lines to me. Tim, I could never become a Christian because the church is full of hypocrites. So I want to take a minute to just respond to this idea, because there are many people who feel this way, and for these people, this is something that really does trip them up. I want to preface what I'm about to say by acknowledging that a lot of people really have witnessed some bad things in church, and I'm not going to try to defend those things. I don't mean to diminish anyone's pain. So I want to start right here with a humble admission. Sometimes bad stuff happens in churches. Why is this? It's because the church is made of people, and people sometimes do dumb stuff. That being said, let's talk about the problem of hypocrisy. What exactly is a hypocrite? First, let's talk about what a hypocrite is not. A hypocrite is not a person who believes or even says one thing and then does another. If that's what a hypocrite is, then really, we're all guilty. We've all made up our minds that we weren't going to do something, and then we did it anyway. We've all said that we were going to do something, and then we failed to do it. We all have ideals that we have failed to live up to. We've all made promises that we didn't keep, every one of us. That's not being a hypocrite. That's being human. I've been involved in churches most of my life, and quite honestly, this is where most people are. They're honest people who fail to live up to their own hopes and dreams. An actual hypocrite, however, is something different from that. The word hypocrite means play actor. This is not the honest person who simply falls short. This is the person who falls short but refuses to admit it, and then also criticizes other people for falling short. This is something that Jesus gave stern warnings about, and it's something you don't want to give space to in your life, not even a little. Hypocrisy is not something any true Christ follower wants anything to do with. Rightly understood, Christians aren't people who think they're better than other people. Christians are people who know they are sinners in need of forgiveness. The Bible says that all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. It also warns us that the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life in Jesus Christ. This free gift of forgiveness and eternal life is offered to every person, including you. So now, I have a very important question for you to think about. Are you going to allow the actions of a few foolish church attenders to keep you out of heaven? Are you really going to let a few bad experiences determine where you will spend eternity? Because that would be a very foolish thing for you to do. Listen, do yourself a favor. Don't let anyone or anything keep you away from the life that's available to you through Jesus Christ. Reach out to God. Open your heart up to Him. Forget about everyone else and know that Jesus loves you and He died for your salvation, and that's all that really matters. If you're interested in learning more about Jesus and how to start a new life with Him, I want to invite you to check us out at Bethel Church. Here's some information to help you connect with us. We're here to help you discover this wonderful life that God has created us for.